And good evening and welcome to the Week 7 edition of News West 9 Game Time presented by Lithia All-America. It's our second of two shows on the night. The only station in town that stays late and gives you two full shows of highlights and scores on Friday night. I'm your co-host, Trevor Tankerson.
And I'm his co-anchor, Chase Horn. It was a beautiful night for football in West Texas.
Was.
We have a ton of highlights and scores coming up, so we're going to get the night started off right. And don't worry, Trevor, I got this week's Game of the Week. Our Game of the Week, well, it was an easy choice this week. It's the night the Battle for Midland took place, with Midland Lee and Midland High squaring off at Grande Communications Stadium. The Rebels enter the matchup with a 3-1 district record, good enough for third place in 2-5A, while the Bulldogs are tied for fifth at 2-2. So not only was pride on the line tonight, but more importantly, playoff positioning was as well. Midland High has won the past two Tall City Classics, and they hope to make it 3-0 tonight to break a two-game losing streak, and we'll pick this one up in the first quarter. Who else but Jason McAfee from 12 yards out takes the direct snap, goes off tackle and in for the score, 7-0 Rebels. But Midland responds. Here the Bulldogs fake out me and the defense, Xavier Martinez.
That's okay,
a big game down the near sideline. It is okay because I eventually found him. Big game for them. That moves the chains, and a few plays later, Sam Grimes goes deep downfield. Perfect pass to wide open DeAndre Goodley behind the defense. Gives a little Superman show the S on the chest. Ties the game at 7 apiece. Second quarter, same score. Lance White with the carry for the Bulldogs around the outside in the end zone for the touchdown. Check out this celebration. So excited. Buddy pushes him over, but it's okay because he scored. 14-7 Bulldogs after that. Lean out with the ball. And again, McAfee breaks loose. A big run down the far sideline. Cuts it back in. That's a big 35-yard gain. That will lead to a lead touchdown. They miss the extra point. Now check this game out. The score explodes in the second half, and it's Midland Lee that comes out on top, picking up a huge win over the Bulldogs. Final on that one, 41-38.
Staying in the 5A ranks, the Permian Panthers got to enjoy a bye week after their big come-from-behind win over Tascosa 2 weeks ago. That put them at 2-2 in district play, tied for fifth with Midland coming into the day. Tonight, the Panthers were hoping that 2 weeks of work paid off as they welcomed in San Angelo Central Bobcats, coming in at 4-1, second place in the district. Panthers looking for their second straight win, sporting some silver pants
tonight.
I like the silver look. First quarter, Jorian Wilson, well, he liked them too. And he looks good at them.
Made him run better.
Dance, yeah, they make him run. Look at the shifty moves inside the 10. Sets up first and goal, third and goal now from the 2. They hand it to Wilson. That's always a good decision. Touchdown, Permian, 7-0 Panthers after the extra point. Central's first possession, midfield, third down here for Mickey Scott, but it's going to be dropped by Justin Hall. Big defensive play there would force Central to punt. Now after that punt, Permian driving right back down the field and capitalizes. Wilson, carry up the right side, finds a hole. Extra point was blocked and returned for 2-13-2 Panthers lead. Central would answer right back quickly. Mickey Scott over the middle to Landon Sawyer, wide open for the score.
Two-point
conversion. It's good. Somehow it's a 13-10 game just like that. But Mojo, Chase, well, they were game tonight,
yes,
to say the least. They answer back. Wilson up the middle. Nice cutback move right there.
Great
third
game for that
touchdown
young man
of the half. And Permian sends a message to the rest of the district tonight. They beat second place Central 48-38.
Very big win for head coach Gary Gaines and the Permian Panthers. Let's look at some other District 2-5A action. Lubbock Coronado taking on Abilene High. First quarter, no score. Eagles march right down the field. Marcel Porter from the Coronado 30 gets a nice run. Tiptoes in the sideline, stays in. It's 7-0 Abilene High. And the Eagle defense watertight in the first half. Cameron Wilborn tripped up for just a little gain there. He's not going anywhere. And a few plays later, check this out. Greg Hewitt drilled by Miguel Espinoza. Knocks the ball loose, and Brandon Seeley scoops it up. Scoop and score. Other way for 6 points, 14-0 Eagles. Now some more great offense from the Eagles in the second quarter. They're showing why they're the first place team in the district. Evan Abbey pump fake. Wide open, Sam Barry turns and dives in for 6 more points. And the Abilene would roll in this one. Like those cheerleaders, as you said in the early show, 49-0, your final score.
One more 5A score for you from tonight. Abilene Cooper, second straight shutout of district play. Last week, of course, they beat Midland 41-0. Tonight, Cooper puts the egg on Amarillo Tascosa, 42-0. And just an interesting night in District 2-5A. Midland Lee and Midland, as
great
they said
game
before, great game. And as I said, you can always just throw records out, even though
both
of them are
good. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Those
it
big rivalry games.
three-point game. Lee comes out on top, and Permian, it looks like that bye week did him some good.
Yeah, a huge win for those guys knocking off San Angelo. They were in second place coming into the night, and Permian on the outside looking in.
Yeah, Central with only one win, one loss coming in. And Permian sending a message. With Midland High losing, Permian will move up in the standings. So big night for a couple of teams in District 2-5A. And that's just the beginning. We're nowhere near done with our second game time of the night.
That's right. Still many more highs and scores coming your way. So don't go away. You're watching News West 9 Game Time.